Demagogues. Today I'm going to discuss the most talked about album on planet Earth at this precise moment. Yes, the stupendous Abbey Road. So, this was the Beatles' last album released in 1969 and featuring one of the most iconic covers in rock history, showing our four long-haired heroes crossing the zebra outside the studio in St. John's Wood. I've crossed the zebra hundreds of times and had photos taken on four occasions, to my knowledge. 1983, when they opened Abbey Road up studio number two to the public. I was there. 1993, 2003, and 2014. Eddie House. The album received mixed reactions upon release, but is now as respected as Pepper and is currently topping album polls, including mine, all over the place.
Can you give me protection
Although
from yourself?
This is a great album to hear all the way through. It feels more synthetic than Pepper and isn't as historically important as Pepper, it has to be said.
Yeah. Just altogether pointless.
But this is still a wonderful album. Let's get going.
Who is it?
Get up in the morning, slaving for bread, sir. So that
well, the history, not much to say really. I think I got this just after Let It Be in 1981, 1980, something like that. It was from Max Records, of course.
I'm gonna run your ragged. Woo!
And it was quite exciting because I only knew the Blue Album songs at this particular point, so there was a lot of interesting stuff.
Take your stinking paws off me, you damn dirty ape!
And it was one of the more exciting albums, I can tell you that much.
Where's that Joe Buck?
Where's that Joe Buck?
Yeah, where's that Joe Buck?
I'm Joe Buck from Texas.
And Rico Rizzo from the Bronx.
His name is Joe Buck. He's a cowboy. He just came in from Texas.
Cowboy, huh?
I ain't a for real cowboy. But I am one hell of a stud.
Then how come you ain't scored once the whole time you've been in New York?
Because I need management, goddammit!
Let's go.
Hey! I'm walking here!
You were going to ask me for money?
How much is this going to cost me?
$20.
You big Texas longhorn bull!
No rich lady with any class at all buys that cowboy crap anymore. Frankly, you're beginning to smell. And for a stud in New York, that's a handicap.
I should never have asked you up here.
More goddamn faggots in this town.
I'm gonna use you. I'm gonna run you ragged.
Hey, listen, don't get sore or anything, okay? I don't think I can walk anymore. I'm scared. You know what they do to you when they find out that you can't walk. Oh, Christ.
Everybody's talking at home. I don't hear a word they're saying, only the echoes of my mind. People stopping, staring, I can't see their faces, only the shadows of their eyes.
Not bad, not bad for a cowboy.
I'm going where the sun keeps shining through the pouring rain. Going well.
She's a pretty nice girl. Someday I'm gonna make a mine. Oh yeah. Someday I'm gonna make a mine.
A weird and unwelcome surprise to end the Beatles' musical career. The missing note could be symbolic, but best forgotten, or else the book The Love You Make would have to be renamed Someday I'm Gonna Make Her Mine.
Carpet Day! No!
The album gets a bit messy at this point. Lots of lazy half-assed songs kicking off with this tune. But if you think this is bad, check the anthology version. Another unfinished tune which was chucked into the mix. There was this couple of lowlives live around the corner. Terry Bagnall and his wife Pam, and we used to call her Polythene Pam, and she used to shuffle down the road. She later died, and the woman in the newsagent down the road, he come in, she says, "Terry, haven't seen Pam for ages," and he lifted up this carrier bag and said, "She's in here." "I'm just glad all our songs were about love," said Macca in 1995. Maybe he forgot this one wasn't. Maxwell Edison is a psycho nut on the loose with a claw hammer. It's a catchy tune, but I wish they'd made more of an effort to be serious on it. Love the reprise of "You never give me your money," but the sing-along rugby chorus doesn't suit the Beatles' vocals. "Sleep pretty darling, do not cry." Apparently ripped from a 17th century Civil War period ballad. Once I saw that nauseating Boots Christmas advert with this on it, it just makes me want to vomit now. I'm sorry, it's not one of my favorites anymore. Everybody's laughing. Everybody's happy. Louis the 14th is the other monarch to get a shout on this album. A sleepy little tune which is very enjoyable in spite of the crap nonsense lyrics at the end. Would have been a colossal way to end their story, but some idiot tagged the unforgivable Her Majesty at the end instead. On the negative side, the repeated chant of "Love You" goes on a bit too long. However, Macca's slightly nervous last two lines give the song its real power, an ending of sorts, but that really came when John was killed. "I don't want to leave her now. Over slushy, over emotional and overrated. I hate the strings, the horrible guitar solo and the sickening video. Although it's one of George's more accomplished songs, I don't like it. Sorry." "I'm with you now. Do you know what? It's a tragedy that not enough work was put into this song, which could have been a standalone rock and roll classic. I mean, the lyrics hark right back to the 50s. But what lets it down is the modern sounding instrumentation and Macca's vocal, which although brilliant in many ways and in some places, still for some reason makes it end up sounding like a take two or something. You know, it would probably be at home on the anthology if we'd never heard it before, and we would have thought, oh, that's quite good, but it's not as good as it could be. It's just sad, really. It eluded the Blue Album for those reasons, I'm guessing. Having said that, once it's on, I'm singing. It could have been a great song. Sadly, it's just an album track and nothing else. One day another singer will do this song justice that the Beatles didn't. Monday's on the phone to Monday. Tuesday's on the phone to me. love the thought of some cheap tart sneaking in through the window. Its gobbledygook lyrics hinder it slightly, but it's still a masterpiece. Sunday's on the fall to Monday. Tuesday's on the fall to me. Oh yeah. In an octopus is God with you. In an octopus is God with you. The Ringo track is basically Yellow Submarine Part 2. It's one of the more famous tracks that's been neglected by contemporary commentators. Probably not enough edge for the millennials. I still enjoy it when it's on, and it so does my wife Avis. She crossed America on the Blue album. Come together. Opening side one, Lennon meets Chuck Berry in this anthem to free love. Great fun, but shamelessly overexposed in the last 20 years. Come together right now over me. Oh yeah. One of my favourites, a brilliantly original song by John, and it's just one I just could put on over and over and over and over and over again, and I love the way it ends as well. Down, 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 down. She's so heavy. Love it. It's bonkers, and talking of bonkers, this reminds me of my first wife, Debbie. She used to get paranoid when I used to sing this, because, yeah, you know, she never gave me a fucking nickel through her life, the bitch.
Ma'am, can you give me protection from yourself?
Because the world is round, it turns me on.
Such a gorgeous track. Almost too glorious in its own right to be included on any album. But then where do you put it? John reversed the bars of Moonlight Sonata or something to find the tune. But who's that hurting? For my part, I love how it ends the film American Beauty. And I love the distinctions included. Even though Lennon tried the same thing on Whatever Gets You Through the Night with tepid results. Because it's a diamond of a tune, and it's in my top 10 favourite Beatles songs. There you go, fantastic.
It's a 10 out of 10.
And at number one, for the first time, Mr. George Harrison, with his wonderful tune, Here Comes the Sun, diddy-diddy. Anyway, this is George Harrison's finest song, on the same level as Lennon McCartney. Just for this brief moment, it's beautiful and it makes me happy every time I hear it. George, you are definitely not Garbage Day, this album. But it was downhill thereafter, basically surviving off Beatles era scraps and new songs which were appalling for the most part. Check out Blood from a Clone and The Light That Has Lighted the World. Yep. By the way, check the Steve Harley and the Nina Simone versions of Here Comes the Sun. Essential summer classic.
It's a 10 out of 10.
The greatest decade in the history of mankind is over. And as presuming Ed here has so consistently pointed out, we have failed to paint it black.
Well, it's a matter of debate whether Abbey Road is the greatest album of all time, but it's certainly in the top 10. I love it. It's easy to listen to all the way through and a fantastic way to bid farewell to the greatest group of all time. Yes, sir, the Beatles. Even if Let It Be was released afterwards.
Yeah, just altogether pointless.
Goodbye, and I hope you pass the audition.